So, how do you curve text like this in Illustrator? There are four steps to make this curvy text here and this badge text work. I've also got a couple of bonuses. I will show you how I created this skull here using just one click, using the new generative AI features in Illustrator, plus two design rules that'll make your badge design way more professional. Also at the end, I'll show you how badly my drawing went. All right, my name is Dan Scott. I'm an Adobe certified instructor and I teach design courses at bringyourownlaptop.com. Today, we're gonna curve some text together. Before I start with a design or like a tutorial here, I get a mood board together and then I do some hand drawings. This didn't go well. Once I've got a rough direction, it's time to curve the type. So step one, we need a line for the text to follow. You can use the pencil tool, you can use the arc tool. No one actually uses that. You can use the pen tool that you either love or hate. For the pen tool haters, you can use the curvature tool. Oh, it's magic. And I bet you've never used it. Use a circle for the badge, you can use a star, you can use anything. All right, step two. Now, if it's just curved text like this, you can just grab the regular old type tool and just click anywhere. You can start typing. For a complete shape like the circle or the star, if you do the same thing, it'll fill the shape like this. It's not what we want. So for kind of like the badgy circle thing, we need to use the official type on a path tool. So just click and hold down this tool, hold, and grab that one, the type on the path. Click on the edge where you want to start typing and start typing. Now for either the circle or this curve, gonna have to pick the right size, then pick the font the only way I know how. Duplicate, click in the character panel, and then hit down, down, down. Duplicate again, and then more down, down, downing. Does everybody do this? Anyway, keep doing that until you realize you've spent the entire morning picking fonts. One thing you will have to do with the font you pick is the tracking needs a little bit of adjusting when it's on a curve. I like to use the shortcut option on a Mac, Alt on a PC, and just use the left and right arrows to adjust the tracking. Track, track, track. I've got all the shortcuts if you do want them in this handy PDF. I'll put a link in the description for it. All right, it's time for step three. This step is also combined with the very first do not do this. Do not click the little white boxes. Try to create this other text box that you end up with like this kind of setup. You know you've done it. It is never what we want. So undo, undo, undo. What we're looking for is actually just above, see this icon here, just above or below the white boxes. We want to click, hold and drag using this. This adjusts where the text starts on the path. It's a little different for our circle badge option here. Changing the start of the text using the same way is just really tricky on circles. So it's easier just to set the whole bit of text to be centered and actually just rotate the circle to where you need it to be. Okay, so if you just needed the curvy text like this, no more steps really. But if you want this like badgy style text, you need to figure out how the heck to get this text on the bottom of the circle. Ah, and you, my friend, need step four. This is a funny one. It is not some sort of magical setting that you've missed. It's more about caveman design. We just need two of them. Ugh, me need two. So I'm gonna duplicate my circle here, I'm gonna change the text. I'm gonna go up to type on a path options, and then click on flip. Click okay, and it kind of works. Just need to rotate it around and then line them both up. There you go, text on the bottom, no magic. Two separate circles. One last helpful thing, I'm gonna select both, go back into those same type on a path options, and I'm gonna align them to center. And quickly, before we get to the bonus, I wanna show you two design rules that'll help your badges look awesome. Take a look here at my mood board. Check it out, there is one thing in here that kind of combines them all, connects them all up. And it's hard to see until you see it. And then you're like, oh, they all have it. Can you see what it is? It's to do with the font. If they're in a badge, they're all uppercase. It's madness. Look, even this one, lowercase when it's straight, but look, they've gone uppercase when it's in a badge. They just look better when they're all uppercase. Check out mine, I've done mine in lowercase, meh. But uppercase, ooh, come on. And the second design rule is text width. If you haven't got much to fit on your badge, you might look to use some of these wider fonts here. Okay, it's one of the filter settings in Illustrator. Conversely, if your client wants you to squish like a whole sentence into your badge, you can filter by narrow fonts. Just make sure they're all uppercase. All right, my friend, it is time, bonus time. How do we make that skull with one easy click-ish? It's all using the new generative AI feature called Text Vector in Illustrator. You find it up here under Window, Text Vector. I'm gonna start with drawing a square on my artboard. I'm gonna type skull into the prompt, and we get these kind of more illustration style versions. I want more kind of a simplified logo icon type thing, so In the drop down here, just change it to icon. Same thing, skull. Here you go. Check out these. And maybe adding to the prompt something like minimalist or geometric or one color, just to simplify things down. There we go. Cool, huh? Loads and loads of skulls. Now I'm gonna kind of pick it apart. There's lots of ungrouping here. And I could go on explaining this feature, but really this is an entire other video and something we cover in the full Illustrator Essentials and the Illustrator Advanced course. If you're keen to do those, there'll be links for those in the description. Come check it out, make all sorts of cool stuff. But for now, I promised I'd show you my drawing. I don't want to. I was like, ooh, I'll do some dynamic videography while I draw some awesome stuff. And it turned out like this. I'm not proud. There you go. You don't have to be a good drawer to be a good designer. All right, we curved some text in Illustrator. We weren't able to go through every single detail about curved text. I do go into a lot more detail in my full course. And what I'll do for you is there's two videos in that course, that paid course, that I will make free for you, and I'll put a link in the description. So if you want to get a bit nerdy with me, go check those out. And for those of you who are looking for a little bit of practice, what I'll get you to do is I want you to create your own badge and share it with me. Okay, so use your first and last name, maybe your company name, and make a badge and share it with me. Share it at any of these places here, okay? Tag me or put it in the group. Just make sure you use the hashtag BYOLCurvy so I can find it and so that you can do a search and see what everybody else has made. But remember, it's not a beauty pageant. Don't worry, just practice time. Okay, so do something, share it with me. I'd love to see what you make. And that, my friends, is the end of Curve Typed in Illustrator. Ka kite anō, family. Bye.